and take a look at the back. It's pretty thick too. A little taller towards the bottom end of the yard. I'm gonna try to get it knocked out here and then up the other side. So you've seen it before, but hey, we're gonna try out a new, as you call it, an upgrade. We just had a new set of drive wheels on the 920, so figure had all original wheels on it, so I got those swapped out and we're gonna see how they do. So this lawn's a little wet and just had some rain come through, so we'll see how the traction goes. And got new blades on there, new set of blade bolts, so we're ready to rock and roll. So stick around. All right. Nice and clean. Kind of had to double cut this because it was so wet. Cut it on 2.5 and then went back over it with 3 and dispersed all the clumps. So here's a quick look at the backyard earlier. Nice and cleaned up, trimmed out, everything's blowed off. So again, just a short little video, one little yard this evening. Actually a holdover from the other day, so things just didn't work out to get to it. It's a little further out, so we're gonna wrap this one up. I'm gonna hop in the truck here for a second and I have a couple things going down the road, but we'll be right back. All right, everybody. Just got in the truck. So, sorry about the sun in the back. Maybe it'll go away here in a minute. So. But easing back out of the neighborhood. Looks like I just got that one done. And it's just been one of them stretches, y'all. Everybody goes through it. You know, you have these little things, one thing after another. It was, you know, my tires have started slipping a little more. So, it's kind of slowed me down. On the jobs, just having to take a little more time to turn so I don't burn the turf and places and things like that. And then yesterday, obviously it was the blade bolts, which again, you know, it's just one of them little things. So I had to take time out to go track those down, pick them up at my dealer, so I could get that fixed, which caused me to have to buy another set of blades for the other mower, which I hadn't intended on buying yet, but that's how it works out. So we got it taken care of. We got a job knocked out yesterday, one to get done, and everything ended up working out. Like I say, it's just one of them stretches where you have things that, you know, things just happen, whether it's equipment breakdowns or issues with customers and things like that. That stuff just, you know, it goes and it comes, and it's just a part of the business. So try not to let it get you down. Just try to keep grinding on and get the jobs knocked out. You know, you have weather delays and things like that, so nothing out of the ordinary, just one of them stretches for me. So we got the blades on, obviously. Got the 920 out here today, new blades, fresh some new blade bolts. I got me some anti-seize to kind of help maybe from them freezing up and putting quite as much torque putting them in and out. So we're going to head on down the road. Like I said, got a new set of tire drive wheels on the 920, so it's about time for that. Still had the original wheels on it. I'm going to also, before long, purchase the front casters. So those are also original. So we're going to spruce up the old gal a little bit, if you want to say. And the 94R, it's been a little while since I spoke about it. It's doing a great job. It's become my primary trimmer for really a couple of reasons. One is just minimizing the wear and tear on the 90, the FS90R, my old trimmer. I still use it, still bring it with me on occasion, especially when my brother-in-law's helping me. So we'll switch off using it depending on where we're trimming at. And eliminating wear and tear on that. It's a lighter trimmer. There is a noticeable difference in the low-end torque or low-end power. But for your general, everyday, average trimming, just trimming out a job, nothing too thick, too serious, it does perfect. I've gone and tested weight on a couple of trimmers because they talk about how light some of these other trimmers are. I think the 94R is more comparable to, I believe, Echo's 225. And I actually think, in my opinion, that the Echo is a little heavier. Not much, but I could tell a difference. But again, a lot of people still like the Echo. And I've gone to some of the battery-operated equipment, mainly that Steel makes. I haven't really gotten into the Milwaukee. I've seen some Echo stuff and kind of picked it up. And it's maybe a little bit lighter. I don't think it's as noticeable a difference as some people say. But again, that's just my opinion. So there's a lot of people out there that love it. It's got its pluses and minuses like any other piece of equipment. So just a little, talk about some of my equipment, some of the things that's been going on. One little small job that waving at a gentleman sitting beside the road back here in his yard. So a little southern hospitality there. And just some things that's been going on my end. I hope all of y'all are doing good. I try to keep track of a bunch of other people on YouTube and just kind of see how their channels are doing and some of their jobs and things that they got going on, whether it's Johnny with Blades of Grass, Johnny with Upscale Lawn Care, Gerald down in Georgia with Clean and Green, Cody and Courtney with ProCut, Danny with Lanier Lawn Care. Just as the list goes on and on, a bunch of great people. They all do great work. It's fun to watch them. You learn a lot from some of them. And that's what it's all about. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm going to quit rambling here. I'm going to get on down the road, heading back towards the house, stop, pick up some fuel for the mower, some gas in it, and fill up a gas can. So, again, y'all take care out there. Thank everyone who has taking the time out to watch the video. Thank everybody who has subscribed. I picked up a couple new subscribers recently, so y'all, welcome to the channel, new subscribers. I appreciate each and every one of you. And just want to say, y'all, be safe, take care, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks again.